to survive. And we will keep surviving. Humanity survived. Our ancestors have destroyed the world, and we had to pay the price. With over 100 years without sunlight, but we have prepared ourselves for our chance to make things right. They stole from us a life of happiness. Still, we will make the best of it. Even though Mother Earth is grim and tainted, we have managed to survive. And we will keep surviving.
We finally left the end zone. Just look at this beautiful scenery. It's marvelous. Even though it's a bit different from what we had pictured, we were able to secure a few basic resources and are storing them in our bus. I'm glad we prepared ourselves well for this kind of scenario, especially since our inventories in the end zone ran low. Don't forget that if you need additional information, you can look at our survival guide at any time. done. Everything you need to know should be right here. I think the time has come for us to at last build ourselves a new home here. Before we can construct buildings at all, we have to assign the profession builder to several settlers so that they can take care of construction contracts. In general, it's your responsibility to decide which tasks are important and how our settlers are supposed to be distributed to attend to them. Builders will be ready as soon as construction contracts have been issued. The first thing we ought to do is to establish a working water supply. So we'll move on to our first construction contract. Place and build a jetty by a lake in the vicinity of your town center. Very good. The jetty was completed as planned. Now we have a place where we can collect water. There are other possibilities to gather water too, but we can obtain and store water from different sources, like a jetty, rain collector, or well in the cistern. The cistern should always be in close proximity to a water source so that our water carriers don't have to walk too far. We have now installed a working water supply, and water is now transported from the jetty to our cistern. Consider hiring more water carriers if you don't have enough settlers available. You can never have enough water in storage. We should focus on food production. It's important to ensure the supply right from the start. A gatherer's cabin, a hunting lodge, or a fishing hut can directly remedy the situation. I suggest starting with a fishing hut, since we're already located near a lake. Good work. We've now taken care of our basic supply via food and water. Make sure that you have enough food and water on hand at all times, especially if you want to upgrade your settlement. A population that grows too fast can quickly unbalance your food and water supply, bringing major difficulties for you if you don't watch out. Crops are another excellent way of getting food, because they constantly grow as long as the soil is moist enough. Each seed has different yields and growing times. This means that it could take some time until you're... Looks good. Remember that we need the widest variety of food sources to stay healthy. You should also plan ahead for drought periods that might come when it's not going to rain. Stock up on food and adapt your production. At the beginning, we don't have much scrap, wood, or other resources. We could build a production building, but to obtain resources as fast as possible, it's best that we start gathering right away. Assign a gather all resources task. All the settlers who haven't been assigned any profession by you are going to accept these kinds of tasks. Thank you. Since we now own plenty of resources, we can start to build a real production building. Then you don't have to always make efforts by hand that collecting is taking place. Production buildings are not only easier to manage, they're also distinctly more effective than simple tasks. Don't place production buildings too far away from your settlement. You'll be able to change their working area at any time later. Right on. The best thing for us to do now is to build a forester's lodge to automate our supply of wood and make it more effective at the same time. Foresters are not only able to chop down trees, they reforest areas with trees as well.
Thank you.
good job. You might want to change this building's working area later on to tell your workers where they should get their wood from. Ah, and for your information, if you want, you can also tell your forester's lodge that they only ought to attend to reforesting in it. Very good. Now we ought to take care of collecting scrap. Scrap is one of the most valuable resources because the quantities present are limited, and we can recover other resources from scrap, unlike the task we just had.
Thank you.
you can change the working area for the scrapyard, too. We can recycle scrap into 4 additional resources: cloth, metal, plastic, and electronics. We'll do that shortly, but for now, we ought to take care of your set. Our people want a place to sleep and live. Cabins fulfill their need for safety and privacy, and increase the confidence of their inhabitants. In other words, building cabins increases their willingness. Besides cabins, you can also provide sturdy houses and shelters as housing. Sturdy houses withstand sandstorms better and have an increased storage capacity to boot. Children living in houses gradually fill up the house's stockpiles. Settlers do not reproduce in a shelter because they lack privacy. Let's return from our excursion into housing and refocus on scrap. With the help of a recycler or refinery, scrap can be sorted into 4 different resources. A recycler always takes scrap apart, one resource at a time, while a refinery automatically... you can instruct your recycler to produce a different resource at a time. It's important that you focus on the resources you really need, at least in the beginning. Cloth? Happy settlers are industrious settlers. That's why we ought to look after our people and protect them against the surroundings and dangers, like radiation. So, let's start. We categorize environmental radiation into four levels. No radiation, low level, medium level, and high level radiation. The radiation changes constantly and is influenced by weather and contaminated rain. Protective clothing helps to protect us against the... The tools we brought along from the Endzone are slowly but surely running out. So now, let's focus on manufacturing new tools. The tools will help us to work effectively. We'll need metal for that, so we'll prepare for production by building a... Thank you. With our lovely new tools, we are now prepared to work effectively. Should you ever run out of metal, keep in mind that you can also instruct your workshop to manufacture tools from scrap instead of metal. Though they won't be... Down in the end zone, we had sufficient time and resources to educate ourselves properly. But our children don't have this luxury. We ought to build a school and pass on what we've... perfect. Besides the fact that educated children work more effectively, we'll also teach them to be more careful with their protective clothing and tools. Now that our population is starting to grow, we ought to again turn our attention to the topic of food production. We're already accumulating fish and tilling our fields. A gatherer's cabin will now enable us to... Very good. As you can see, the gatherer's cabin is an effective possibility to get food quickly. But watch out. After a drought, it's going to take some time before the plants have regrown. As is the case with most buildings, here too, you can relocate the working area at any time. Although we are sufficiently supplied at the moment, our survival depends on diligent planning. If we can lay out a plan for an orchard, then we can start to plant. The orchard has been laid out, and the trees are already beginning to grow. Similar to crops for farming, trees need some time until they are fully grown. But once they have grown, they can be harvested again. Our gatherer's cabin gathers food from the surrounding forests. However, there are any number of other plants there which we can use as well. These plants can be gathered by an herbal hut. The herbs. done, we can equally utilize the gathered herbs to convert them into medicine later on. It might happen that an illness breaks out in our settlement from time to time and spreads among our settlers. That's why we always ought to have enough herbs on hand. Radiation is the main reason why the health status of our settlement can decrease. Although our settlers already use protective clothing to shield themselves against environmental radiation, it might occur that our sources of water become contaminated. We should start to filter our water to prevent this from happening. We will need a great deal of charcoal to accomplish this. The charcoal kiln will burn wood to produce charcoal. can use the charcoal in conjunction with a filtration system to purify our water. Unfortunately, our cistern is not able to do this. Only the water tower has the necessary equipment for this capability. It would be a disgrace if we had to demolish our trusted cistern just to erect a water tower in its place. What we ought to do instead is upgrade the cistern itself. A water tower can store much more water and provides workplaces for a lot more water carriers than our old cistern. Our new water tower is up and ready for action. Good work. Filtering the water is an important next step because clean drinking water is a key mainstay. Let's begin with filtering our water. To save on charcoal, we ought to ensure that at least a little bit of water, not contaminated by radiation, is being stored in our water tower. Water gained from a well is never contaminated by radiation, so it suggests itself for that purpose. Then we can use the remaining charcoal to produce better protective clothing. Good work. We are continuously taking steps towards being better and better equipped to be able to survive in this hostile environment. Filtered water is a precious asset. And later, not only our water can become a hazard for our settlers due to radiation, our food can too. We ought to erect a decontamination post. very good. The decontamination post is going to supply all buildings that stockpile food and are located in it. It's true. We should never forget that even when we optimally prepare and protect ourselves, we're still going to lose friends and members of our family time and again. Okay, the cemetery will help us to quickly get a hold on ourselves and focus on the tasks that lie ahead. It's not a pleasant thought, but that's the way things are. At the very least, we're pioneers, aren't we? Maybe we ought to distract ourselves to lighten up the mood. We can erect a number of buildings to increase confidence in our settlement, including, for example, a campfire or a pub. In this situation, however, our best option would probably be to upgrade our town center. Settlers can visit the new town center, and by doing so, increase their confidence for a while. Very good. The new town center not only gives us more storage space, at the same time, it functions just like a campfire, too. Settlers can visit the new town center, and by doing so, increase their confidence for a while. Now that we have made... Our settlers can get sick from time to time. Settlers who have become infected with a disease can die from it if they're not treated. Settlers will go to a medical facility to have themselves treated and will be admitted there, provided that... With this step, we have ensured the survival of the settlement for a while. Very good work. Since more and more children are being born these days, we should start to plan for the long term. While cabins are a good way to get settlers to start a family, they only provide limited space. This can quickly lead to people having to live on the street. Allow me to suggest to you that cabins be provided only in a very targeted manner in order to control the population growth of your settlement. Nothing is worse than not having enough resources to provide for everyone. We ought to build a shelter to be able to provide other inhabitants with a roof over their heads too. Very good. Remember that when children grow up, they're going to leave their parents' house and look around for a new place to live. It might happen that they don't find any home at all. We ought to build a shelter to be able to provide all inhabitants with a roof over their heads. I've already pointed out to you that it could become very dangerous if we were to run out of food at some point. Since a lot of people are going to be living in the new shelter, we ought to provide them with access to food in their vicinity. A hunting lodge can look for wildlife in the surrounding area to bring a little meat to the menu. Perfect. The hunting lodge equally provides us directly with food, but it functions somewhat irregularly because it relies on wildlife in the surrounding area. Nevertheless, it can be indispensable during a drought. However, wild animals can not only be shot, they can be captured too. When a wild animal has been captured, it can be brought to a pasture and served there as livestock. Animals captured by a hunter are brought to a pasture where they are tended to and cared for by herders. Some animals produce resources such as milk or eggs. Other animals can only be slaughtered to eat. You ought to find out for yourself which type of animal brings you which benefit. On each pasture, you can choose which type. You must provide water for the animals you keep on your pasture. This enables them to survive and reproduce. When enough animals are fully grown, now your herders know how they ought to handle the animals. And now that you've already captured several animals, don't forget to instruct your hunters to hunt. With our increased production, our stockpile is going to run out soon. The supply routes for our production buildings are getting longer and longer, too. To tackle these problems, you ought to build a temporary storeroom and have roads laid out. Temporary storerooms increase your settlement's general storage capacity. Place them in a targeted manner in order to shorten the routes for goods between your production buildings. Roads are equally a great benefit because settle the to improve the whole thing even further, we can build a market to improve logistics at the settlement. Besides being an enormous stockpile for resources that is even able to store water, the market is responsible for... Logisticians are able to amass resources from the whole settlement and bring them to the market. This improves the flow of your products and leads to your settlers having to walk shorter distances to fulfill their individual needs. The combination of these attributes, the larger your settlement gets, the farther some settlers have to travel to get to all of the food you produce. To make life a little easier for them, you can build a food station. Logisticians who work at the food station will collect... With the new food station, your settlers are now able to supply themselves with food directly on site. If your settlement is supposed to grow even further, distributing food at your settlement is going to prove to be extremely practical. However, your settlers not only need food to survive, they need water too.